Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. So some brand new news, Newton is coming back. Now if you don't know, Newton was an email application that has been on and off released for quite a while. I'll explain some of the details today about the re-release, also some of the changes that they are making to this email application, and hopefully give you some of my opinions about whether you should jump back into this application, because obviously it has been up and down for many years. So without further ado guys, let's dive into today's video. Before we dive in, a little word from our sponsor. So folks, this month here on Keep Productive, we're sponsored by Woven. Now for those who don't know, Woven is a powerful and smart calendar application that can assist you in smart scheduling, managing your meetings, and planning your week ahead. They've released some new features that can be really helpful for remote workers and people working from home, including Home View, so you can get important information about each meeting and glance ahead. Zoom integration to make it easy to immediately join a video conference call. Analytics, so you can see and analyze how your team spend time. And iPad support, so you can use Woven across all of your Apple devices. Now, as many of you guys know, I'm a user myself, and my personal favorite feature is the one-time scheduling, which allows me to batch meetings, plan podcasts, and interviews. Now, we're really grateful to have them on as a sponsor, and thanks again to Woven for sponsoring Keep Productive this month. So, there are naturally a few updates in this platform, so let me take you through a little bit of a timeline first. So I actually worked with Newton between 2016 and 2018, and it was in about September 2018 that they announced they were closing, and naturally that was what I thought would be the end. But in February of 2019, the likes of Essential, which is a smartphone software company, actually decided to purchase it and naturally transfer all its assets over to that company. Now, Essential actually closed about a month or two ago now, in February time, about the year anniversary of purchasing it. They closed both Essential and Newton. And of course, that's the second time it's shut down. So I thought, you know, it's going to be over naturally. But now, a small team have actually bought the rights to the assets from Essential, and they basically want to start it up again. And I think it's quite interesting updates of what they're actually releasing. So let's dive into them. So it's interesting, in their blog post and the article that you guys will see in the link in the description, you'll notice that they actually tried purchasing Newton before when it first shut down. They had a huge interest in keeping the application alive. The Newton community were naturally massively engaged with this application and wanted to see it keep going. And of course, it was that sort of time when a lot of people were eager. So they had a natural interest in it. And what I quite like about these chaps so far is that they seem very interested and community focused. So let's share a few of the changes that they are looking to make. So the first change is long-term planning approaches. So apparently they are looking, obviously, to get things rolling again with Newton, but to actually look at the long-term by making this application open source in future use, in case the company does go down, because they want this project to not go to waste. So that's a really nice long-term approach. And they're also looking at self-hosted servers and sort of that setup if people wanted that in the future, without necessarily keeping the company running. So that's a really positive start, sort of a very long-term approach to this one, something I'm not sure Newton actually released originally. So they will be keeping with the same pricing, $49.99 per year, and I think that is the perfect pricing. I remember back when I started at the company, and they just released Newton, and I was in charge of like the community and marketing aspects. Well, not all of the marketing, naturally, but we were obviously selling this product at $49.99. People had Gmail free. You know, now some of these services like Superhuman are charging $360 a year, and actually state a bunch of them like Polymail $120 a year dollars, and that's quite expensive. And actually, Newton sort of rolls perfectly into those pricing. Like $50 per year is not bad. So that's something that they are keeping. I'll talk a little bit about the discounts and offers they're providing a little bit later. So they also stated that they're looking to improve the customer support side of it. So apparently the Newton had bad customer support. I think we had experiences where people had really good from just feeding into some of the conversations on social media when they were really good and really bad. So it sort of wasn't consistent, at least. So they're looking to provide their emails inside of this conversation so you can directly reach out to them if you have any sort of problems. Now, looking at the features, they've actually stated within the first 3 to 6 months, they plan on delivering new features most requested by users. Apparently, this is namely dark mode, fixing some of the superchargers and bugs, and they look at squashing a lot of bugs in the first 6 months. And they don't want to, you know, overpromise stuff, but they want to fix the core foundations before they jump into brand new features that are completely unfounded by the community. They've also made a statement about the privacy policy. They also want to say that immediate, quick changes to protect users' data better. There was a lot of sort of hoo-ha about the GDPR stuff and also how Newton utilized the data that was provided. And a lot of the wording, I think, was very general stuff that a lot of email applications include just to be able to access your emails in being able to provide them on their service. But they're looking to improve better privacy, which is definitely a good statement. They're definitely touching on a lot of the points that Newton users were suffering from. They also stated that they can easily delete your account and take ownership for your data faster than before. And they're also looking to integrate PGP-based integrations or encryption, sorry. So they said stay tuned for that. Now, you're probably wondering, $49.99 a year, like, what happens if I had a Newton account? Or what happens if I was a previous user in the past and I, you know, left because clearly it shut down? Well, they stated that if you've already subscribed to Newton app now, you will be added 3 more months to your subscription for free. So that's anyone with an active yearly account. Obviously, a lot of people would have done it in January and paid for it. So naturally, you'll get 3 extra months, which is really good. And also, if you had cancelled your subscription, of course, because of the shutdown, and you want to come back, they're offering a 20% discount. And you just have to reach out to their general email. Also, if you apparently want to refer a friend and they subscribe to Newton, you'll get a 20% discount and also 3 more months of Newton. So they've really baked in a strong referral scheme, which is definitely good. So talking about all of those updates, Newton is actually a great positioned email application at the moment. A Superhuman Rise, Mixed Match tools are all really expensive and very popular at the moment. So Newton being priced at $49.99 is actually a decent price. And when we actually first released it, it was like a bit of a conversation, like, that's an expensive email application. But now it actually falls into the sort of medium priced email applications, which makes it a lot more attractive. Of course, you know, $30 a month for Superhuman, that's almost an entire Newton subscription. So you can see the appeal that this application has got. Naturally, Superhuman, a lot of benefits to it, but definitely positioned well in the market. So if you want my opinion, I think I quite like this new team because they're a team. You can see the people in it. They're not like a large company. And they also look like they're fixing the stuff that the community have found issues with, which is definitely something that you want from a team. And it feels like they're going a bit more sort of on the ground versus up in the air, in which you didn't really know what Essential were getting on with in terms of Newton. So it's definitely a better experience. So they will be re-releasing. I will be sort of testing the waters again. It was an email application for me for 2.5 years. So, you know, I don't necessarily jump back into it, but I want to have a look at how I used it before. So folks, a big thank you. Hopefully you found this video useful. All of the links and relevant articles and documents and references will be below, so you can go and check out their press releases. But a big thank you. I will talk to you all very, very soon. Stay tuned for more videos. And thank you very much. Make sure you subscribed as well, and see you folks very soon. Cheers, everyone. Bye.